This is the Jakarta Light Rapid Transit, a 5.8-kilometer long transportation scheme that was constructed to improve and transform Indonesia's capital city's worsening traffic congestion. It is a project equipped with six stations, which starts in Pagangsa Andua Station, located in North Jakarta, and it also houses its depot and heads all the way to Velodrome Station, located in East Jakarta. The entire 5.8-kilometer project, however, may sound short, but is actually only the first phase of the construction. Further plans have been laid out to ensure that the entire Jakarta Light Rapid Transit system is going to be used by Jakarta's enormous and growing population. The first phase, which was already completed and set up for its commercial operation way back on the 1st of December 2019, took about 4 years before the entire project was finished, as the project was officially assigned way back in 2015. Future extensions have already been proposed, and some of them have shown that the Jakarta LRT may have two potential planned lines. This first is the so-called Northern Line, which will start from Pagangsa Andua Station and head all the way to the Jakarta International Stadium, and from there head towards Rajawali. This Northern Line is expected to start its operations by 2024, but only to be fully completed by 2025. The next line is known as the Southern Line, which will start from Velodrome and head to Klender, and from Klender head to Halim. But there are still options for proposals and may still change in the future. The rolling stock equipped with the Jakarta LRT is provided by a South Korean firm known as Hyundai Rotem, which is a company that is part of the Hyundai Motor Group. The rolling stock produced was provided as a total of 16 cars, where each set would have two cars and be able to carry as many as 278 passengers, making the entire LRT scheme have 8 two-car train sets. These used rolling stocks are expected to have a top speed of 80 kilometers per hour, which is just about right considering that the line length is quite a bit short. The project's ownership and construction are operated by a subsidiary known as PT LRT Jakarta, a company owned by PT Jakarta Propintindo, or JakPro for short, which is a company known for constructing numerous projects around Jakarta's infrastructure, utilities, and properties. The construction was also reported to have the help of Singaporean-based ST Engineering Electronics, where they had successfully produced platform screen doors. Finally, it was reported that the project cost of the entire first phase of Jakarta LRT had amounted to a whopping 2.78 trillion Indonesian rupiah, or just around 187 billion US dollars, which comes to around $30 million per lane kilometer. The expansion plans for the Northern Line are cited to have a project cost of around 15.78 trillion Indonesian rupiah, or over a billion US dollars. The first phase project costs are just about right, since, according to numerous reports, this boils down to around $15 to $100 million per lane kilometer. But fascinatingly enough, some LRT infrastructures built in the US go up to as much as $178 million per lane kilometer. But the project cost is mainly affected due to many factors, from cheaper labor to availability of commodities, and at times whether there is due diligence from the project managers, since projects are plagued by problems due to overruns. The entire Jakarta LRT project is expected to have 143 kilometers of total length and approximately 100 stations within the entire Jakarta area. The procurement of the capital used, on the other hand, for the Jakarta LRT's implementation was a loan disbursed by Bank Central Asia. This project is also not to be confused with the upcoming Greater Jakarta LRT or Jabodetabek LRT, which is a separate project that has yet to start its commercial operations. These light rapid transit systems and other major transportation overhauls were all necessary to help keep traffic low in Jakarta, a problem that needs to be changed as soon as they can. Accommodating the growing population is a must, as traffic's main problems are not only due to time waste, but productivity. Once the LRT is fully implemented and running, as expected from its 100 stations going through 143 kilometers around Jakarta, this would inevitably bring a huge economic boost to the city and the overall national economy. This is, again, mainly due to the upward increase in productivity, and even because it can save Jakarta's population time and money. The cost of vehicles has been significantly going up, especially with the huge oil prices as of late, while even inflation has been hitting vehicle prices. Anyway, what do you think?